Hi everyone. Today I'm working on a frame assemblage, and I have some of the work done, but I started with just one of these old cabinet cards that come in these cardboard frames that fold up and sit on your table. And I've already taken this picture off of this one, but that's what I started with. So I'm sure you're all familiar with those. And I took the picture out of this dapper gentleman. Took it off, it came out like this. I took the frame part off. So I just have the picture. And then I took the easel part and covered it with that big collage paper that I made. I actually used all the rest of it. And at the folds, it was quite worn. I need some glue under there. But I put this cool vintagey looking washi tape at the junctions where it bends just to reinforce it. Did it on both sides. So that's where I am. This is the wrong way, this way. So then this can sit like that. So this becomes the front. So that's ready to go. And then I have this like jewelry box. I guess it was the right color to go with that, so I didn't feel like it needed to be painted or covered. And I'm going to put the picture in the frame. I'm going to mount that on the block so that when I put it on the frame, it'll have some dimension, and if I wanted to put some assemblage pieces behind him, I can. We'll see when we get to that point. So I have some pieces picked out, just some vintage game pieces and some old hardware pieces that will go on, but first I wanted to paint around him, so I'm just going to do that now. I'm just using like an antique white color. I'm just going to go around the outside of him. Okay, the paint is all dry. I changed my mind on the box. Instead of using that small box and having the gap here between the photo and the stand, I have a larger box that I'm going to mount on there like that. And then his picture will go in here, and I will do some assemblage inside of there, and then the frame will be on top. So that's the direction I'm headed, and I may put some plexiglass in between the box and the frame when I'm all done. So next steps. I did go around and paint the outside of the box that same off-white color. I'm going to do the same thing to the inside edges, and then I may age this paper. I put some dictionary page in the bottom of the box. So that's what I'm going to do next, and then when that's done and dry, I'll be back. Okay, so off camera I painted the sides of the box with the same off-white that I used on the photo. And then I used watered down fluid acrylic burnt sienna and just went over the book paper and the inside sides of the box, because that's really all that will be seen. But remember, the the frame will be on there, and I may do something on the frame too when I get there. And then I took my dressmaker's tracing wheel and red heavy body paint and went around the photo and the inside of the box. You can't see it real clearly inside, but I did it anyway. Those aren't dry. You can see the dots. It's just fun to do. So I'm going to dry the little dots, and then I think I might cover up some of his suit and do a little painting there as well, and then we can start putting the assemblage pieces on and put it together. Okay, off camera, I painted his suit with red, and then put some of those off-white dots with the end of my paintbrush, and then I used my pit pen with a brush tip to make the little marks on his suit. And I jigged up his hair a little bit, fluffed it up. And he has silver across his mouth, and the reason for that will become apparent in just a little bit. So I decided I want to raise him up. So I mounted the photo to just a scrap piece of artboard. And I'm going to put checkers on the back so that he can stand out a bit from the back of the box. I think it's just more interesting when there's some dimension back there. All right, so anyways, he's going to be on the checkers. And then I think I'm going to take, I have this token, I don't know what it was from, it has a number and then it says KMP. I just took my pit pen and went over the numbers and then wiped it off, and some of the ink was left down in there so you can see the number better. But yeah, it's a brass tag, I don't know from what. But I think I'm going to put that on his chest there, and then a wing nut, line those holes up, and I think I'm going to thread it through with some wire. That's the first thing. And then we have some washers. I could only find two different sizes, but that's okay. I really don't care. But we're going to put those right over his eyes. And then I have these little tiny resistors. I think I pulled them out of an old calculator or something. But I thought I might stand those right up in there. And maybe I'll paint the ends of those red. And then if I can figure out how to do it, I was going to put dice on the sides of his head. And then I have these springs, you know, just like from the inside of a ballpoint pen. And I was going to put like little antennas, attach it to the dice. See if I can get it to sit there just so you can get an idea. And give him little antennae. Whoop, that goes this way. But the springs will have to come into the box, I think, if I'm going to put the plexiglass on it. Yeah, definitely. So anyways, that's my plan. So I'm going to spend a little bit of time with my E6000 and get these elements put on there. And maybe I'll go ahead and attach the plexiglass. Actually, this isn't really even plexiglass. It's like a heavy acetate cover almost. It has a blue protective film over it on both sides, so that'll come off. But right now it's keeping it clean. So I'm going to work on those little elements and maybe get him put in the box. And when I'm done with that, I will be back. I'm going to use a heavy darning needle to come up from the back through those holes to attach the metal pieces. Wish me luck. Okay, I'm back. all the assemblage pieces are glued in, and he's glued into the box. I did put these two pieces on with a little bit of copper wire. Hope that's in frame, you can see it, but I threaded both ends through and made like a loop on the back, and then threaded them up and then threaded them back down through. So this piece can move and this piece can move a little bit. So that's kind of fun. And I had to play with the wires a little bit to make sure that they were going to be seen when the frame gets put on. Some of it might get cut off depending on how low I put this. So that's that. And I want to do something with this frame, and I think I'm just going to go around the outside with some black paint. And I have carbon black in the golden high flow. It's opaque, so I'm hoping that's going to work just fine. So I'm going to do this, and I will dry it. And then I can finish putting this together so you can see it. Almost there. Okay, that's much better. I like that. I have these two dice that I thought would be good down here, color-wise. So I'm going to glue those on. I'm going to get this glued on, and then I will reveal why he has silver on his mouth. So stay tuned. Okay, I have the plexi on. I used E6000. That's what I used to glue on the assemblage pieces, too, that are glued down. I glued the dice onto the frame, and the frame will cover the edges of the plexiglass or the acrylic sheet, which is acrylic, it's not plexiglass. I guess they're both the same, but this one's real flexible. It's fairly thin. You can cut it with an X-Acto knife. So that's what I used. So this just needs to get glued there. And he will get glued to here. And then this little saying is going to go right there. And it says, silence is golden, duct tape is silver. Get it? That's why he has the silver over his mouth. Just a little goofy thing, but I liked it. So. Yeah, probably something I would have said to my kids back in the day. So anyway, I'm going to glue this down and get my frame glued onto my box. And then get the whole works glued onto the stand, and I will take some still photos for you to see at the end. So thanks for coming along with me while I created this today. It was a lot of fun. I love doing these. They're just challenging in some ways and fun and meant to just be funny and silly and, you know, nothing serious for sure. So if you haven't subscribed to my channel, I'd appreciate it if you did that. Come back and watch me make more art, and ring the bell. You'll get notified when new videos go up. And in the meantime, oh yeah, give this video a thumbs up. I'd appreciate that too. Share it if you like, And in the meantime, go make some art. Bye.